Hello, good morning all of you. This is the essay from human reproduction. Okay, this is the second one. Okay, describe the male reproductive system of man. Draw a neat label diagram of it. The male reproductive system consists of a pair of testes, then accessory ducts, external genitalia, and accessory glands. Okay, these are the parts of male reproductive system: a pair of testes, accessory ducts, external genitalia, and accessory gland. Here they mention some of the accessory ducts like epididymis, vas efferentia, and some more accessory ducts you will be learning when we move forward. Let us first talk about this one. What is this one? Testes. Testes are also called testicles. How many are there? A pair. What is their shape? Oval. What is their color? Pinkish. And what are testes? These are the male sex organs. Okay, you got it. Okay, they are located outside the abdominal cavity. Where are they located? They are located outside the abdominal cavity. Located here. Okay, outside the abdominal cavity, where? Within a pouch. What do we call that pouch? Scrotum. Scrotum maintains low temperature of testes. That is 2 to 2.5 degrees Celsius lower than normal body temperature. Okay, testes are also called testicles. How many pair? Shape, oval, pinkish. Their male sex organ located outside the abdominal cavity within a pouch called scrotum. Scrotum maintains low temperature of the testes, that is 2 to 2.5 degrees lower than normal body temperature. The cavity of scrotal sac is connected. The cavity of the inside the scrotum, there is a cavity called scrotal cavity. The cavity of the scrotal sac is connected to the abdominal cavity. Here in the abdomen, there is a cavity called abdominal cavity. Here, abdominal cavity. In the scrotum, there is a scrotal cavity. Those two are connected by a canal called inguinal canal. Here you can write inguinal canal side heading. Inguinal canal, what does it do? Okay, the cavity of the scrotal sac is connected to the abdominal cavity through a canal called inguinal canal. Inside the scrotum, testis is held in position. Okay, for example, this is the testis, this is the scrotum. Here is the testis. Inside this testis, the scrotum is held in position by, here there is a structure which is connecting these two, testis and scrotum. Okay, what is that one? Gubernaculum. This is the scrotum and this is testicle. Okay, this is testicle. Okay, here the connecting these two, there is a structure here, gubernaculum. The testis is inside the scrotum. This is the scrotum. Inside the scrotum, testis is held in position by, what is the structure? This is called gubernaculum. Okay, which connect the testis to the base of the bottom of the scrotum. It is connecting the testis with, this is the testis. Okay, this is gubernaculum, which is connecting testis to the bottom of the scrotum. And also by, testis is also held in position by spermatic cord that connects the testis to the abdomen. And the anterior side of the testis, there is a spermatic cord. Okay, which connect the testis to the wall of the abdominal, to the abdominal wall or wall of the abdominal cavity in the inside the abdomen. Okay, that's about testis. In this paragraph, what you learnt: inguinal canal, what is inguinal canal, and what is gubernaculum. And testis is held in position by gubernaculum. This is the gubernaculum and this is the spermatic cord. Okay, each testis is enclosed in a fibrous capsule called tunica albuginea and covered by tunica vaginalis. Each testis is enclosed in a fibrous capsule called tunica albuginea
and covered by tunica vaginalis. Okay, let us see here. Okay, this is a tunica. Imagine this is the tunica albuginea. And above this one, there is another one, tunica vaginalis. This is the tunica. This is tunica vaginalis. Okay, testis is covered by, testis is enclosed by fibrous capsule. This is called tunica albuginea and covered by, above this one, there is a tunica vaginalis. Tunica albuginea, this tunica albuginea, it extends inwards, it goes inwards and divides the testis into testicular lobules. The tunica albuginea extends into the testis and forms septa. This is one septum, this is one septum that divides the testis into about 250 testicular lobules. Each lobule, okay, this is one lobule, this is one lobule, each lobule contains 1, 2, 3 highly coiled seminiferous tubules. What are present? Seminiferous tubules. Okay, this is the first part about human male reproductive system. Okay, try to learn this first part, then I will upload second part as well.